I would like to welcome you here already at this symposium. This is the symposium titled Philosophy of Information and subtitled The World as a Computer. Is that possible? We will see how things will continue this afternoon and how they will develop. Everybody is expecting a very interesting afternoon, and let us therefore start as soon as possible with the KL Pol Public Symposium. We have four experienced speakers here, and they will tell you their view on the world. They are, or let me first say the world, if I give you in the terminology of philosophy of information, four notions. First, the world. Second, information. Third, reality. And in particular, reality seen with the means of arts and information. And then internet, that is, I would say, the means for everybody to have the information directly available. The four speakers are Peter Adriaans. He is the most ambitious one, I believe, because he believes really that the world is a computer. And he will tell you about that computer. Then we have Keith Devlin. He talks on information, and of course, as you may understand, I will later on introduce the speakers more elaborately than I'm doing at this moment. We have Tine Wilde. She is talking on remodeling reality, and especially with a focus on art. And already, if you look a little bit around, if you believe what are the caves over there, then I have already your attention on the caves. These caves are part of art. Art and installation, but it will be explained later. And finally, we have John McCarthy. In fact, and that is an open door to you, John McCarthy needs no further introduction. I would like to introduce him later on, but also he is a guest of honor here. You know how in America and in the Netherlands, we treat a guest of honor with a warm applause. Welcome, John, to be here. Thank you very much. I think that is the start of an exciting afternoon. My name, by the way, is Jaap van den Herik. It is also polite to introduce yourself. I have the privilege to be your afternoon session chairman. I'm a little bit falsely announced as computer chess expert. Not that I'm not an expert in computer chess, but as Peter is talking on the world, I think I have also more abilities, capabilities, and skills not to be announced now, but at least to tell you that they are present. Anyway, this afternoon is organized by three organizations. First of all, the KL Pol Foundation. It is the KL Pol Foundation for Education, Art and Sciences. In fact, the idea was founded by KL Pol. First of all, let me introduce KL Pol, Bert Pol. He was a journalist with the NRC. He was also a founder of the Hollands Maandblad. And he also founded, as you know, in that time it is still there, the cultural supplement, the cultural, I would say, additional magazine, not a magazine really in the time we have now, a magazine with the NRC, but at the time that he started it. And he was a front runner, I would say, from the current magazine. So that is one of his, very good credentials. He is a literator himself and is also an editor. And he thought we should establish the connection between art, science and culture, especially at a time that the ministries decided otherwise, because then at one time, it was 1985, that they took away culture from the Ministry of Education and Science, as probably some of you remember quite well, and that was the start of his ideas. Pol died in 1992, and so as a remembrance to him, they organize, and we are now part of it, the sometimes public symposium, because that was what Pol's ideas were, bring art, science, and culture to the public. Having said that, the organization now is helped by two institutes here from the University of Amsterdam. first of all the Institute for Logic, Language and Computation, the ILLC, and also by the Human Computer Systems Laboratory, the HCSL, both from the University of Amsterdam. But as you know, universities don't have that much money, so they couldn't organize this alone, and so they looked, even the Kyle Pohl Stifting, they looked for sponsors, and I have the pleasure to announce you six generous sponsors. First of all, three are part of NWO, that means the Netherlands Organization for Scientific Research. They are NBO, NWO Cognition, NWO Exact Sciences, and NWO Humanities. Moreover, and probably there's always a fight between them, I had to announce them first, but NWO was with three of the departments. The Royal Academy of Sciences, Science should be mentioned in Dutch, the KNW, the Koninklijke Nederlandse Academie voor Wetenschappen. Finally, it is my pleasure also to mention two specialist organizations. One is a scientific foundation, the Bet Foundation, called after Evert Bet, the in Netherlands famous or well-known logician. And moreover, sometimes the money should come from somewhere. It is my pleasure also to mention the publishing house, Elsevier. So far, so good. That for the general introduction. I now hope that it is 2 o'clock and everybody is settled here. That is that as soon as possible, I would like to give the floor to Pieter Arians. But of course, not after that I have introduced him on his, I would say, publications and on his name in the Netherlands. Pieter, where are you?
Here.
Ah, okay. Pieter, we start with Pieter's story, which is a very personal story. He is telling his view on the world. In fact, he is telling his orientation to the world. Pieter is a professor at the University of Amsterdam on learning and adaptable systems, but to many of you, or probably all of you, he is well known for his sailing performances. It's not the place and the time here to dive into details in this area, but anyway, he can have lectures of hours on that topic too. He is one, as Jan van Bentham called it yesterday evening, he is one of the very few original researchers who, as computer scientist, fully rely on his own software productions. And if you may understand, that is quite, then you have quite some courage. Yes? Anyway, he is also a philosopher. He is an, as it is in the announcement, entrepreneur, but I would call him a businessman if I look how he sold his own company, Cellogic. But also he has scientific parts. He is a member of the Advisory Council for Science and Technology. And finally, and that's important for us in Amsterdam here, he is the chair of the board of CWI. I think I have mentioned enough credits. I wouldn't like to tell anything on computers as the world because it is his turn to do so.
Peter. Thank you. Thank you.